Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Marvel Contest of Champions, and kind of back to Marvel Contest of Champions. We're at the website, and I'm figuring because I've done a lot and I've got a lot of crystal opening videos, it's time to look at a video that you guys helped make. This video is for those who joined my live stream on the 27th of August 2016. You'll know that I asked some questions about who is the most wanted characters. So what we're going to do today is we're going to have a look through Comic Vine, which is one of the sources that I use to get my comic book history from, and then have a look at some of the quoted abilities of said characters, and, well, hope for the best that in the future we get these characters. So without further ado, let's get started. So the first character is Quicksilver, and people want him. You know, people want Petro Maximoff. They really do. Since the most latest X-Men films, Days of Future Past and an Apocalypse, he's got back into people's kind of good books. Well, I think he was in people's good books from the start. Very popular character, as who wouldn't want super speed? So his quoted abilities on here are agility, attractive male. That's not really an ability. Duplication, enhanced mutation, stamina, super speed, and unarmed combat. So a lot of these kind of like past people say, well, that's not really kind of applicable to what will happen in Marvel Contest of Champions. But yes, to a degree, it would do, apart from the attractive male side of things. Duplication, I think, would probably be based on super speed. So it's like the same kind of theory as, well, duplication could be for Nightcrawler, because he can put 2 points at the same time. He can hit and then be quickly in the close proximity to the rear of the character, therefore hitting in another shot. Same thing can be said for, I think, the L3 on Nightcrawler. I think that's where we get the duplication thing, but it's been very kind of airy-fairy with saying that that is a power. Now, if they were to do something in the game, I think they would have to be very tactful. They got Nightcrawler right, and that's the thing about these mutants with I can't remember what they used to refer it to. It's there was a scale of kind of like how much the strength of the mutation is. They kind of put it in a kind of power threshold, like he's a level 5 mutant or something like that. Super speed is one of these ones where it conquers all. It doesn't matter about anything, but super speed is one of those really high up there superpowers to have, because a lot of things become null and void, like weight and against speed, and if we kind of quote it against Days of Future Past and an X-Men Apocalypse, you'll know what I mean, especially with the Sweet Dreams scene. And do watch that scene, because it's a fantastic scene where he saves the family from other mutant kids from the Xavier Mansion. Great. I liked X-Men Apocalypse. A lot of people didn't. I thought it was brilliant. Really, really decent. Paves the way for a decent future. But anyway, I digress. Fantastic character. As long as they link up synergies between Scarlet Witch and Magneto, I think we're going to be having a very, very happy time. When they're doing the fighting structure, it may be best to do something where, I don't know, if they jutted the characters so it looked like he was going very kind of fast. So if you know what I mean, like with your hand just kind of juddering like that, as if he's going, you know, a bit fast with striking abilities. But they may save that for L2s and L3s. I don't know if they do it for L1. But that's the difficulty. I hope they do enter the character into the game, but they've got to do a lot of work to do it. So the second character mentioned was Cable. Now, Cable is pretty cool in any case. I'm just trying to find some decent pictures. So there he is, looking badass. Look at... There's some great art here, and some of the comic books are fantastic. I've got a Cable and Deadpool comic book to read. Or I might actually do that for a competition for the 3K. Not sure with that, but he's such a badass character. So great camaraderie with Deadpool, great rivalry as well. I have done a video on Deadpool and And Cable, so do check that out. It's in the Deadpool Week playlist. But, right, so abilities. These are the most important things now. Agility. I didn't think he was that fast. He moves pretty fast for a big guy then. Attractive male again. Astral projection, blast power, electronic interaction, force field, gadgets, implants, intellect. Yeah, to be honest, he's gonna have like and stamina, super strength, telekinesis, telepathy. The character gets a lot of like, you know, it's the son of bloody Cyclops, for God's sake. A clone of Jean Grey. Oh right, so Madeline Pryor is a clone of Jean Grey, but I was surprising that she would kind of get the full powers of Jean Grey in order to then produce a child with Scott Summers that was so unique. I hope to use the boy as a weapon against the Apocalypse. So obviously the character has to be more substantial and have a lot more. So maybe this would be a very excellent end boss as opposed to a playable character. Because of the abilities, it may be best that this character could be an end boss. Because the time travel thing would be more applicable to a storyline. That would be a brilliant storyline to have something like that. And then include things like Deadpool saving the day, have the X-Men in it, Bishop. And Bishop will go on to in a minute. I jumped the gun then talking about that character. Really, really think this would be a fantastic character to add to the game. And it was a great suggestion by the people in the live stream. There'd be too many synergies. I'm very happy with Kabam doing more of a link to synergies nowadays, where you get multiple ones now, because they really got synergies wrong with any kind of comic book backstory to them. Regardless of people going about, you know, oh well, it's all about the crits, the crit damages. Yeah, but the fact of the matter is, this is the core subject where the game is based on. They don't call it Contest of Champions of nothing. It's of Marvel and of Marvel characters. So we need to give these the kind of the content core more kind of looking at, and they're doing that, which is great. Right, on to the next one. Mystique is a kind of a, again, this is one of those difficult ones with Quicksilver. And I actually talked about this. Wanted, and we're talking about Wanted characters. I talked about this with Grave and Tim, the aspect that, well, what if the character could mimic other characters' attacks? So say you're going up against an Iron Man. Iron Man decides to do arc overload, and then Mystique, because she's then taking the body, she's mimicked the character. It's kind of like a copycat thing. Has now taken arc overload, and now is arc overloading at the same time. That concept is pretty cool. I like that. So she's adaptive. She's got agility. Attractive female. Chameleon. Claws. Oh right. Okay. Sort of. Elasticity. Escape artist, healing. Okay. Insanely rich, intelligent, intellect, even leadership, longevity, marksmanship, shapeshifter, stamina, stealth, tracking, unarmed combat, weapons master. Yeah, I think Mystique would be a badass character, really badass, and it'd be great if she was added into the game. But I don't know. I think the thing is, we had such a lack of mutants, and then all of a sudden we're getting so many. I feel that, you know, if we were to add any more mutants just now, it would be too much. I feel that we should have had a lot more to begin with, but because that's where the popularity of this game should have been. Should have been about X-Men sort of first, because it's X-Men, a big collective. We've got Avengers, you know, big collective. You've got West Coast Avengers. You've got loads of different characters in different kind of ways, but it would have been great to get these out of the way first, because they're very popular. X-Men are extremely popular. So synergies wise, a lot of the bad people, you know, we potentially Juggernaut, potentially Magneto, rivals, Wolverine, family, Nightcrawler. They don't touch on that, which is kind of disappointing because I think that's a core aspect. Touch on the relationship with Nightcrawler and Mystique. But people could say, oh, it's from an alternate reality or different kind of comic book arcs. Fine, whatever. But for a game perspective, a new, I think they should use like some kind of new ability, which is kind of like a copycat type thing or mimicking. But they take, the Mystique takes abilities, doesn't take abilities, but mimics them, copies them. So fighting style, maybe the character itself. Making a very adaptive character, similar maybe like Maestro with regards to what type of character, what kind of class the character is. Maybe a new type of class, maybe something that's that just requires more alphas to rank this character up. Yeah, that would be quite cool because the character is adaptive to classes. Obviously, you could say it is mutant. Well, I suppose you still have to argue the point is mutant, but the character could take on different forms, like we said, taking on Iron Man's form. So Mystique is facing off against the Juggernaut. She can then become unstoppable. All look like Juggernaut in it. This is the thing, same thing with Quicksilver. They've got to box this clever if they decide to do the character. They can get it so wrong so easily. So the more time spent on this character, the better. Next one, Spider-Man 2099. This would just be a standard carbon copy, I think, of the ones that we've got. Symbiote's the same to standard Spider-Man. Miles Morales is totally different fighting style. If I was to have it in, I would probably say the 2099, which looks amazing. It's an amazing looking character. It's the same as the other Spider-Man, but the... It's just so menacingly dark and evil, the suit. It would probably... I'd like it to have the same fighting style as Miles Morales, but I doubt it would. I think it would just be a standard Spider-Man suit copy. Next one, Deadpool Corpse. Now, this is funny because I always thought this was kind of a mock of Green Lantern Corpse. The Oath, okay? Through lightest dark or darkest light. It's a mock. It's mocking the Green Lantern Corpse. Through lightest dark or darkest light. You don't need no bling to join the fight. We're mercs with mouths and so much more. Yippee-ki-yay! We're the Deadpool Corpse. It's a good oath. It's a good oath to have. So, the kind of characters you could look to expect to find. So you've got Lady Deadpool there. Deadpool Kid, Dogpool. Did that make an appearance for National Dog Day? I can't remember if it was in that thing, but if not, kabam, put it in next time. Evil Deadpool, Kid Deadpool, Kidpool, Lady Deadpool, as we know. Major Deadpool and Widow Wade. There's Widow Wade. Oh, Widow Wade. So cute. Right. So, yeah, I think that would be quite cool. More females in the game. No, it can't go wrong with that. I think that it'd just be exactly the same, like carbon copy of standard Deadpool. Not the X-Force version with the power gain. I doubt that highly. Doing Deadpool Kills, Deadpool Pulp, Golden Age Deadpool, and Panda Pool. Jesus Christ. Yeah, I think it'd be quite cool to have. Anyway, next one. Fantastic Four. Nope, Sandman. I'm looking at the wrong thing. Sandman. Sandman is pretty cool. They give it... the thing is about this character is he's going to be immune. If he was put into the game, he would be immune to a lot of things. So, powers, adaptive, animation, attractive man, again, attractive male, chemical absorption, density control, duplication, escape artist, flight, invulnerability, matter absorption, sand manipulation, shape shifting, size manipulation, stamina, super strength, unarmed combat. They would make this guy would be pretty decent. Imagine like being immune to practically anything. To be honest, he's invincible, really, in in a greater sense, unless somebody's got a lot of fire and turns them into glass. But when it comes to, say, enemies, like, you're going to be immune to so many different things. Poisons, you're going to be immune to poisons, you're going to be immune to bleed, you're going to be immune to practically anything. It's any kind of burning, you know, it's like, who would this? This, again, is one of these characters where they have to do it right. They have to do it well. They have to spend time on it as well. Just imagine the fact that the character is requiring to attack and strike, but then they would probably save it for L1, L2, and L3, the ability to go into a sand-like state, or kind of seep through underneath the enemy character and appear the other side to then attack. So the element of surprise, duplication kind of thing comes into effect, where he can kind of, doesn't matter how much sand, he just kind of then splits himself in two, and then they're able to then attack each side. So it would be, I'd like it, I really would like this character, but I really have to do this right. That's vitally important. Yeah, it's a great backstory, very interesting, but they maybe need to do a Spider-Man event in order to kind of make this, to introduce this character more. But if they did this, they'd have to do the Green Goblin, which we haven't covered in today's video too much, well, at all. But the Green Goblin would have to be another one. But I think a Spider-Man event would be really great for questing. Right, next, Fantastic Four. Kind of like chalk and cheese with this one. It's like take it or leave it. I don't really know what to say about Fantastic Four. I like the characters. I think they could be quite good. I feel if you did Mr. Fantastic, it'd be a bit like Miss Marvel, the what's she called, Kamala Khan version. Anything else would be, well, I think when it comes to like Juggernaut would, and Thing would probably have similar abilities. It kind of be like a carbon copy of that, with the L2s and the L3s being different. When it comes to the Invisible Woman, again, same thing with Mystique, all this kind of shape-shifting, like you know, this kind of changing of character is going to be quite difficult to again, the character would have to be science. No, science or cosmic. It's probably got to be cosmic then. Yeah, so that's going to be, it would have to be like science, because that's another argument. Would it be science or cosmic? It would have to be cosmic. If you think that the symbiote suit on Spider-Man changed Spider-Man, it's now cosmic. So therefore, Fantastic Four would have to be, therefore, cosmic. Yeah. But anyway, I digress. When it comes to Johnny Storm, I don't know how to liken that character, what to liken that character to, because I feel that he should levitate or kind of fly. And obviously it's going to be fire. So the character's going to even bleed, burn, incinerate, that kind of stuff. Yeah. I just don't think, the problem is with Fantastic Four, I think they're liked, but I don't think they're liked enough to be put into a game format. But I think the characters would be cool. I just don't think they'd be well received. I think there'd be people, they're like Marmite, take it or leave it. Anyway, on to the next one. Bishop. I want this character. I think this character is fantastic. He's going to have abilities that, the power absorption, imagine stuff like, he'll be able to absorb, like, just like, blocks down, like this, he absorbs all this power, and say, gets like a, I don't know, triple to kind of like, quadruple fury stack with a crit bonus. And then he's able to kind of then just fire out with great ferocity, Imagine that. I think that would probably be the way that that Kabam would implement this character. So abilities, agility, attractive male, again, berserker strength. So he's kind of like, would they give him aspects of Wolverine? That would be very interesting. Energy enhanced strike. I suppose it's with the energy kind of like pulse ray power that he has. Flight. I don't really see that too much. So would they give that or not? Gadgets, healing. So again, this character could be an all-round character. The way that I like Rogue and kind of life-stealing abilities, blah, yada, yada, yada. The healing aspect, again, is a regeneration on this character could make it a real, real amazing character. Put it with Berserk Strength. Put it with what we said about the energy absorption. Then invulnerability. So imagine like a combo of characters. You've got... say the like Luke Cage, we've got then berserker and healing abilities of Wolverine. We then couple that with some stackable fury things like what's he called, Drax, and then who else can we kind of like put it to? I think that's it really. Yeah, so imagine that, just like those characters just amalgamated into one. Especially because he could get like, would they give him a leadership type synergy, so he gets some block proficiency. But then that means that he would have to then attach himself synergy wise to a lot of the X-Men characters, which it wouldn't be ones that we would necessarily like. But still, all these abilities are fantastic. Marksmanship, stamina, yar, super strength, loads. All very, very handy. I know he's got time travel the same as Cable, but I don't know how they kind of put that aspect into the game. So, you know, it's a difficult one to say yes or no and how they would implement in the game. This could be, like I said, one of these characters where they create an event around him, and he's more of an end boss based on his abilities. So... I'd really like, I mean, that's the character in Days of Future Past. It looks pretty badass. Obviously, I really want to see them in these in this attire because they just look like so brilliant. This is what I remember from the animated series. Right, okay. And I do want this. I do want this character in the game. So this is the final one. This is Carnage. Carnage's abilities are, you could say, similar to Venom's in some sort of a way. So adaptive, agility, berserker strength, chameleon, chemical absorption, claws, danger sense, duplication, elasticity, feral, genetic manipulation, healing, intellect, invisibility, invulnerability, longevity, power suit, psionic, psychic, radar sense, shapeshifter, siphon, life force, timer, size manipulation, stamina, stealth, Submariner, super speed, super strength, unarmed combat, wall climber, clinger, weapon master, web slinger. Jesus Christ. This may have to be an end boss. They make this an end boss. Especially with all those abilities. It just, they would make this character be too good if they made it. So that means that they'd probably make it an underwhelming character. The only way to kind of make it a kind of a character within the game with all these abilities, make him an end boss. Make him an end boss for, say, Alliance Quest. Put him in for Act 5. And take it from there, because it's another all-round amazing character. Oh, that looks freaky. This character could be the next big boss. Forget your Thanos, forget your Kang, forget your Grandmaster. So it gives a stat 6-1, 190 pounds, yep, 300 variable symbiote. Oh, I think that's the person. Let's see if there's any kind of other pictures there. But they would make this character would have all the abilities which, and all this, the signature abilities would just be insane, but all the abilities to make this character just too strong indeed. But I don't know, you know, I think it's a good point to end, and it's really kind of important to find out from you guys. Thank you to the guys in the stream on Friday the 27th, or 26th even, 26th of August, to who gave these characters as the ones they want. These were the most wanted characters that I picked up. But if there's ones, let me know in the comments below. You know, is there a character missed? What do you think the synergies and what do you think the signature abilities, or even the abilities of any case, the character would have? So let me know, what do you think, you know, to the characters that I've gone through, what do you think abilities they would have? You know, some should have fury. Why should they have it? Should they not have it? Create your character. Let's create the characters. Maybe that give Kabam a little bit of feedback, and maybe we can send this video to Kabam and just say, look at the comments below. We're helping you build your characters for the game, and maybe bring these characters in as soon as possible. So let me know in the comments below. Build these characters, and hopefully we can get something good. If you like this video, please hit that like button. Really helps the channel out. And subscribe, which can be found on the link after this video in the outro, and also on the button to the bottom right, and anywhere in particular. Thanks again, and as always, I shall catch you on the flip side. Bye-bye.
Hello, I'm Sammy De Tours, head of marketing here at the Rich The Man channel. And if you enjoyed that video, then hit that subscribe button and give the boy a like. Now give me some bloody lettuce!
Yeah, that's nice. It's like what I want to see. Right. Yum. Yum. Yum.
So good.
You're tasty.